You ever go to a foreign country and get a taxi ride to an Airbnb and you have like barely any signal and you have no car and you're just in the dark and you're alone with your kids? Ah! Okay, this is the views we get right now. Outdoor shower, outdoor kitchen. Holy cow, it's so sweaty here. Hey bud. I put all of our food in the fridge in case of bugs. Yeah. Eggs and bacon, but the kids didn't want snacks. We stopped at a place for Costa Rican food. Have some chicken rice stuff, chicken
maduro,
and some meat, and some fruit, and some ensalada. Valentino, any? Why do things always feel scarier at dark, at night? Over here. There's a separate bedroom. Oh, he locked it again. Anyway, it's just beds, I guess. And a bathroom. Over here. Lavandero, right? Except there's no like rigid thing there. Okay, over here. You gonna open the door for me? Yep. Remember Costa Rica, Nicaragua, I'm not sure what other countries. No toilet paper in the toilet. Goes in the garbage. La bodega. Cuartito. Bonito. Vamos para allá. Yes, thank you for showing that. Lovely. We all came from chillier weather, so we have long sleeves and long pants on, and we need a change because it is hot and you miss a wedding. Let's go show this bedroom over here. There's a separate bedroom on the other side of the driveway. Okay, you're gonna open the door for me? Yep. Here we have some friend dogs. Oh, they went back to bed, I guess. They're all chained up though, so. Oh, here's one. Oh, he locked it. I gotta get the key. Who knows what key it is? There's like 10 keys on here. Oh, geez. Just kidding, it wasn't even locked. Ah. What, honey?
We have a bathroom. And then we light off and shut it. And then we have this for washing hands.
And a bed.
Yeah.
Nice.
Interesting to note, there's no like drawers or shelving or anywhere to put clothes. So backpack on the table, I guess, and suitcase is gonna, we're gonna live on the suitcase on the floor.
He said there's not a lot of scorpions, not a lot of cucarachas, and there's a lot of mosquitoes. I think we'll sleep in this bedroom and then my rest of my fam that's coming will sleep over there in those other rooms. Oof, does. First impressions, sweaty. Remote. It's a little scary getting here at dark, like I said, but I'm pretty confident in myself at this point. With just like having gotten used to Nicaragua, and so this is kind of a similar type of vibe. And I know I can speak Spanish, and at least I have signal at some points if I walk around and search for it. So I'll have help from that guy, friendly Julio, if we need anything. I hope the rest of the fam can get here without too many issues, because they don't speak Spanish at all, and I'm not sure if they're getting a chip, like a phone, when they come into the country, and I don't know if I can even contact them. So, good luck to us. I'm a little worried about this situation with a Mr. 1-year-old who loves to run around. Should have brought a life jacket, I guess. Valentina, how's the water?
Good.
Did you touch it? How is it?
Good.
Did you say it's cold?
Yeah.
Also, bowl of fruit for us. I mean, come on. Melons, watermelons. I think this must be papaya, right? And oranges. Yummy. I am noticing a couple of things right off the bat here. First of all, this is only a small proportion compared to what my sister-in-law experienced the very first time we ever went to Nicaragua. But I think I'm feeling a bit of like how she was feeling. Here. Oh my gosh, the mosquitoes. This is why I didn't want to put shorts on, but oof. Valentina, are you resting? Okay. Just the feeling of like, don't know what to do, unfamiliar place, just like completely like lost-ish, and then you're with kids, oops, and then you're with your kids, so it's like, I gotta protect my kids. Some things that are good about this experience so far, positives, a place to put food that's completely closed off to animals, fridge, toilet, because you need to use a toilet when you first get it anywhere. Running water to wash your hands, because that always feels good. Mosquito repellent would be great right now, but I don't have any. And food, we got food. So we don't have to like make food or anything. I think that's all the things. Oh, also signal to be able to contact anybody if we need to. Also electricity, very good to have. It'll probably also feel nicer to have more people here soon. Julio said this place is all tranquilo and everything, and like nobody comes over here, so I'm not really worried about that, but it's still like, you don't really know. Sorry, I don't like talking and eating. Anyway, okay, bye. Also, can't forget drinking water. Drinking water is great. Especially when it's this hot. You want the light off? Okay, she wants the light off, I guess. I was gonna say how weird it feels to sit down and not really have to do anything for once in a long time. Like, yeah, I still have the kids, but it's like they don't want to eat, they don't want water, they don't need anything right now. There's no TV to watch, there's no internet to distract. Nothing to do on my phone because I barely have a signal anyway. So, it feels very strange.